Now I'm going to speak about the Maximizing Math Center or Workstation Packs. For grades 1, 2, and 3, we designed a collection of hands-on center-based activities that you can use in your classroom to work on the concepts that are presented in the curriculum. For grades 4, 5, and 6, we have what we call the Workstation Packs. And for grades 1, 2, and 3, they're titled Center Packs. They're exactly the same in their organization, so I'll speak to the grade 2 one here. When you purchase a center pack or a workstation pack for Maximizing Math at $89, you will receive a collection anywhere between 75 and 80 center cards that exist that address the concepts or allow for hands-on activities to apply understanding of concepts from the math curriculum. This is a component in addition to our Maximizing Math resource. You do not need to purchase Maximizing Math in order to use this center pack. If you've already purchased a core program elsewhere and are looking for some support material to supplement or complement or enhance your math program, this is one of those resources that you could consider. In this pack of centers or center cards, I'm just going to model with a couple here. What you will receive are cardstock center cards that have been printed in color, and what they provide you with are the materials required to run the center, along with instructions that are written in child-friendly language and therefore are written to the students, an example to show what is expected of the students at this specific center, and then an opportunity for some reflective thinking. This is a set of reflective questions that are always provided, and it's your choice on how you want to use them, whether it's at centers, individually in journals, or as a class. There are also ICANN statements that are presented at the bottom here in circles, and these are outline the ICANNs that the center addresses, and it gives a purpose for what they're doing. What I'm going to do is show another card just so you can see the difference. In this card, we have materials that are provided. Anything that's in italics is once again a master that you will need to print from the CD that's provided. For this card, what I would do is post this in the classroom, print off core cards from the CD, collect dice and interlocking cubes, and away I go. These are great for differentiating instruction, as well as for combined grades, and as support to parents who are looking for extra work to do at home. I'll talk a little bit to each of those. For differentiating opportunities, what you'll notice at the bottom right corner is G2. It stands for grade level 2. Each of the center cards or workstation cards have a letter and number that accompany them. If I were teaching grade 2 and the students in grade 2 were struggling with some number concepts and I identified that they were struggling with their number sense, I would consider going to the grade 1 level and perhaps pulling out some centers that address those specific outcomes. To help me do that, with every CD that you, or with every pack that you receive, on the CD component is a table of contents. What it lists is by strand, so patterns and relations, number, and so forth, the titles of all the cards. As you can see here, the first card was titled Pattern Investigator Game, and the second was titled Pattern Race. If I were to look here, the same titles appear. Looking across, it identifies the outcome number from the curriculum that these specific cards address. Therefore, if I'm trying to move into grade 1 for modification, or grade 3 for some extensions for my students in terms of differentiating, I may consider looking at the outcomes presented in the curriculum and looking through the table of contents at those grade levels and identifying which center cards I would want to use. The other piece of the puzzle is also, or the other supporting piece, is that math bags are also an opportunity to provide, that this will provide, and in terms of simplicity, these could be created where you can place each card in an insert or a Ziploc bag, along with its masters printed from the CD, or the materials that you would require as well. And those bags can go specifically home with those students who are still struggling with some concepts, or for those parents who require some support in terms of working with their children on some math concepts. And the last piece is also in terms of combined grades. When teaching a combined grade, for example, grade 3-4, in the grade 4, if I have addressed some grade 4 center cards or placed some of those in the classroom, and the grade 3 students have somehow utilized those as well, the next year when the grade 3s have moved to grade 4, I have enough cards here that would allow me to circulate and choose new cards that the students would not have seen. So it just allows for some refreshing to happen. Again, there's about 80 tasks at a grade level, and that would be enough to probably last you 2 years of one grade level. Center packs, workstation cards make great tools to support your program, whatever method or program that you've chosen to purchase. And so you do not need to purchase Maximizing Math student book or teacher resource for that piece. You can use this independent of that.